To bring donations that we need for the upcoming 2024 Vacation Bible School. We are looking for pool noodles and green 16-ounce soda bottles, that is empty ones. Yet you've drunk it already and cleaned it out for us. If you'd like to make those donations, please bring them into the church office. And remember to accompany your children to VBS this summer. They're going to learn so much about Jesus Christ. It's going to be amazing. Perhaps you have a high school student that's going on to college. The scholarship committee wants to remind everyone that First Lutheran members who are high school seniors or college students, that scholarships up to $1,000 are available. Application deadline is April 30th, so be sure to get that application and get it in so you can get that money for school. Talk to Glenda Craigo if you'd like. First communion class is coming up. Do you have somebody who's third grade or up who would like to join us at the table of God? Saturday, April 27th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., ages third grade and up. Pizza will be served for lunch, and First Communion will take place on Sunday, May 5th, 2024. Please let the office know. Call Kaylee and let her know so I can get the materials for your child. We welcome them to the class and, of course, to the table of God. Church committees are in back of the church. If you'd like to sign up for a church committee, please see the sign-up sheet in the back of the church. And we'd like to remind everyone that there are red fellowship pads in your pews, located at the end of your pew. Be sure to share them so that we might know that you've been here and to greet you in the name of the Lord. Once again, happy Easter, everyone. Big hugs to all of you. Jesus Christ has broken through the veil of darkness, and his light shines forth in our lives, in our hearts, in our souls, in our families. Alleluia. This is a great day. Welcome, everyone. If you'd please rise and share that peace of the Lord with your neighbors. Good morning and welcome, everyone. So happy to have you here with us this morning. We share the peace of the Lord with you all. Welcome, everyone. Good morning. Let us begin with confession and forgiveness. Friends, this is our altar call. This is our opportunity to lay before the altar any troubles, unrest that is upon your heart, anything that is unpeaceful, anything that has broken a relationship. You have the opportunity to give that over to Jesus and start anew. And we start with confession and forgiveness. Friends, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open and all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Friends, if we say we have no sin, we are deceiving ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sin, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us take a moment to reflect upon our hearts and give over to Jesus anything that is troubling. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. As a pastor, this is my favorite part. I love you guys all. Almighty God, in the mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Christ is risen today. Lutheran Book of Worship 151.
Amen.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion.
Inspirational song. I felt like Whoopi Goldberg was going to do it. first lesson this morning comes to us from the 25th chapter of Isaiah, beginning with the 6th verse, and can be found on page 500 of your pew Bible if you would like to follow along. On this mountain, the Lord Almighty will prepare a feast of rich food for all peoples, a banquet of aged wine, the best of meats, and the finest of wines. On this mountain, who will destroy the shroud that enfolds all peoples, the sheet that covers all nations? He will swallow up death forever. The sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces. He will remove the disgrace of his people from all the earth. The Lord has spoken. In that day, they will say, "Surely, this is our God. We trusted in him, and he saved us. This is the Lord, we trusted in him. Let us rejoice and be glad in his salvation." Please join me in reading Psalm 16. We will read by the half verse. "Protect me, O God, for I take refuge in you.
I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord.
Easter is St. Mark chapter 16. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb. They asked each other, "Who will roll away the stone from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. And as they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side. And they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed," he said. "You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him? But go, tell his disciples and Peter. He is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you." Trembling and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. And they said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. God's grace and peace be with you this morning and from our Savior, Jesus Christ our Lord. Jesus Christ has risen today. Alleluia. Let me tell you about a grandmother. This grandmother was holding her grandson, and she looked at her grandson, and they were talking, and, you know, she was feeling kind of older, you know, and that kind of thing. And she said, "Oh, you know, I have all these wrinkles on my face, you know, and one day I'm gonna, well, you know." And before she could finish it, her grandson said, "Jesus is going to unbury you." Oh, wow. Isn't that powerful? Think about that. Our children know the glory of the heavens, that the darkness has been dispelled, and Jesus Christ, the light of the world, comes out of our children's mouths, and they know, before we even speak it, death, even better than us grown-ups do. We often think, let's protect them. Let's put this veil around the children. And yet, they see Jesus like nobody has. They see that brightness of God that strikes your heart and your mind and your soul like nothing else. Jesus is going to unbury you. Wow. Out of the mouths of babes. May our hearts believe in Jesus Christ like any young child. That's what Jesus told us as he was teaching throughout the land of Galilee, as he was healing and preaching and talking to the people. But those who were against him, they conspired, didn't they? And how many times in our lives there is this conspiring that goes on. It takes us down dark paths. It takes paths off the road. It takes us away from our relationships that we want to love so bad. But there are so many sins. Oftentimes we don't like to talk about it. But boy, they're out there. They come in and they start weaseling into our soul and into our mind and into our body and take us off down those dark, dark paths. That's where we've been during Lent. We've taken the sin of Lent and planted new seeds. How many new seeds did you plant in your life these past couple of weeks, right? Because today, Christ the Lord has risen. The sun has broken, and I mean sun, S-O-N, Jesus Christ, has risen to save us and to bring us new life. We can have that new life every day in the waters of our baptism. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Whether it's a little drop of water from an eye drop in a baby in the intensive care unit, or whether it is plunging into the waters of the Jordan River, that Spirit is the same Spirit that comes from Jesus Christ, the Father above, and from the Holy Spirit. And that is with you every day of your life as a free gift. Why? Because Jesus died on the cross. He shed his blood. He is the Lamb of God. Prior to this, the people of God would take a lamb. They'd take an unblemished lamb to celebrate the Passover. And they would slaughter it. They would butcher it, we'd say today in our modern society. And they'd take that blood and they'd put it over the doorpost of their house and their windows. Why? Because in ancient days, when Moses took the people out of Egypt to save them, the angel of death passed over their house. It was to guard and to hide them. But today, our Lord gives us a whole new meaning to the Lamb of God. Jesus himself has become our Lamb. And so we celebrate together the body and blood of Jesus Christ, because he gave it over up for us. He gave everything up for us. It is hard for our minds to imagine the greatness, the mightiness, the power of that unbelievable love. But it's for you. Each one of us, every baby, every child, every woman, and every man. You might think that you have done something that would shame the eyes of Christ. But today on this Easter, he has given you an opportunity to renew yourself, to renew your life, to renew your soul, and to renew your walk in this life. To take that new path, to literally turn it around, he says, and to face the one who loves you so deeply that he would give everything up just for you. The highest heaven, the greatest throne, to come down here and be with us in our humble estate. No king on this earth would ever do that. They try, and they show it on the media, but this one gave everything, Jesus Christ our Lord. Take a look at our beautiful window that we have up here. Our ancestors had that foresight, that forethought to bring this beautiful piece to us. And when the light outside shines through it, it gives us that little glimpse of the glory of heaven. Now the women were coming along down the path. They had known the weeks of desperation and the days and the hours and the minutes that led up to this moment. You could imagine Mother Mary with Mary Magdalene and the other Mary and Salome and Jose was there. And as they were coming down the path thinking, how are we going to move the stone from the tomb so that we can take care of the body of Jesus in the cemetery, right? It was a heartbreaking moment. Could you imagine any mother losing her child? How heartbreaking that is. We know how it is when we've lost a father or mother or someone in our family that we know. We remember them for a long time because we love them, we care for them. And we want to continue their memory in our hearts, and we want them close to us. And here was this obstacle. Look how big it is. How are those women ever going to move it? And we know that some days there are obstacles in our lives, aren't there? There are those big stones that are rolled in front of the tomb. And it seems like we're never going to get out of that death and darkness of the cemetery. How are we going to break free from that? It might be a depression. It might be a sadness about something that's happening in your life. It might be that you're overwhelmed with so many jobs that you don't know what to do next. You don't know if your foot is going to get out of bed and hit the floor. It might be illness or sickness or something medically that you're struggling with. It might seem as cold as that tomb of Christ. And who moved the obstacle? Who is going to move that obstacle in your life? It is Jesus Christ, our Lord, moves that stone, opens the tomb, puts death, sin, sickness, illness underneath his feet. He went to the pit of hell to bring us that love and joy and that light that our choir sang about this morning and that Grace led us in. It's just so beautiful that the light of Christ is going to break into your day. May that be the joy, the love, the healing that you celebrate with the very ones that you love the most this morning. As you go out to brunch and breakfast and dinners, turn to each other and say, the light of Christ is with us, in our family, in my life, in you and in me, and in this community of God. May it break forth in this community, in our town, and all around the world as people and Christians celebrate this Easter morning. Alleluia! Jesus Christ has risen from the grave. Alleluia! Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. Alleluia! Jesus Christ has put the power of death, sin, and the devil under his feet. Alleluia! Jesus did that for you, each person here, and for me. Thank you, Lord Jesus. May you always be in our hearts. Happy Easter, everyone. Amen. He is a risen, glorious word. Lutheran Book of Worship 138. You may remain seated.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen, we believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and we look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this community in Jesus Christ, and we praise you for the glory of this Easter morning. May we celebrate it together with love and hope with all our families, with spouses and with children and grandparents. We thank you, Lord, for eternal life. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious Lord, we have heard of the suffering from Baltimore and the breaking of the bridge. Lord, we pray for the families who are suffering from this cause, and also from the stopping of cargo moving through the river. Lord, we pray that you be with the people in this city and mend their hearts and give them the salvation that comes from you. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious Lord, all around the world, we hear of war and disaster. We pray that your hope and joy come to these places, that you bring peace and harmony amongst people, and that enemies may become known to each other, and that peace may reign on this earth. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious Lord, we pray for those friends and family and people that we know who are suffering illness, who are going through trials, through the hospitals. We pray for those people who are caregivers and take care of people who are in need. Lord, we lift up all the names that are upon our hearts and those who need help and healing this Easter morning. We pray that you give them love and hope and that goodness that comes from Christ. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious Lord, there are many prayers that are upon our hearts. We lift them up to you, knowing that you will hear us. Take these prayers and do your will. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, we will gather our offering.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places praise you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. But chiefly we are bound to praise you for your glorious resurrection of our Lord. For he is the true Passover Lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, and who by his death has destroyed death, and by his rising has brought us to everlasting life. And so, with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and with the creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. We give thanks to you for the salvation you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts, that we may receive our Lord with a living faith as he comes to us in this Holy Supper.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks. He gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Together let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power,
please be seated. Christ the Lord has risen today. You are welcome at his table.
body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
May the body and the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, keep you in his strength and his grace and his mercy. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. And we pray that in your mercy, you would strengthen us through this gift, in faith towards you and in fervent love towards one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Friends, please be seated, and boys and girls, come on up. Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning. Have a seat right up here. Wow. All right. Everyone touch toes. Everyone lift your hands. Everyone stand up. Everyone touch your toes. Everyone, when you go up, say hallelujah. I don't think I heard you. Touch your toes. Ready? Hallelujah. I didn't think I heard you yet. Ready? One, two, three. Hallelujah. There, I heard you. Grace and peace be to each and every one of you. Have you been having a joyful morning this morning? Who knows what's taken place today on Easter? Hope? Jesus Christ has risen today, hasn't he? And that is beautiful news to all of us, because all the darkness has gone away and Jesus Christ has risen for us. Now, when I was a teacher at a school, and you guys can have a seat, we were showing a movie of Jesus and what happened to him. And I was telling the kids, boys and girls, there is going to be a little scary part to this movie. There is going to be thunder and lightning, and Jesus is going to die. And I said, if this is too scary, I can fast forward the movie past that part. And you know what the kids did? They said, excuse me, Pastor Deb, you don't have to do that, because we know the end of the story. We know that Jesus is going to rise from the tomb. The women on Easter morning are going to come, and he's not going to be there because he's risen from the dead. He has put sin and death behind him, and he has done this to save us. They said, as a matter of fact, they said, as funny, as interesting as it is, they said, that darkness, lightning, and thunder doesn't scare us at all, they told me. And they said, actually, that's my favorite part. And I said, what? I mean, children, they think that part is their favorite part? And they said, yes. And I said, wow, children know about Jesus even better than grown-ups. So I want you to know that Jesus Christ has risen from the dead today. And he loves us tremendously. Once again, look up into our beautiful window as the light shines through it, and the light of Christ. Our ancestors here from First Lutheran Church came all the way from Sweden, but nowadays we have all kinds of cultural fun here at this church. And we are so thankful that our ancestors, our grandmas and grandpas, our great-great-great-grandmas and grandpas from the past family knew what a joy it was going to be to build such a beautiful, beautiful church. As a matter of fact, last night we had friends from all the other areas of Lutheran churches here, pastors here, and as they were walking out to go home to their own churches, they said, what a blessing First Lutheran is. They said, this is the most beautiful church they have ever seen. So we try to take really good care of God's house and God's home. And we want you to know that you, as children of God, real children of God, of course, our family out here, children of God, that you are welcome in God's home. And we love you and bless you from the Lord above very much. I have a treat for you today, and I hope and pray I have enough. So if I can have one of the grown-ups here help me pass these out to everyone. Can I? I don't want to hold it over the kids. There you go. Would you hand those out for the kids? And then when you get your treat, you can head on back to your seats with your parents. And everybody stand up. Stand up. And we're going to say alleluia to everyone and happy Easter, okay? So we're going to do it on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. Alleluia! Happy Easter! Amen. Thank you, boys and girls. I hope everyone has a joyful day with their family in celebrating our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You children know the best, and you will teach us all. Everyone have a gift? Thank you. Thank you. Please rise for our final hymn, Thine is the Glory, Lutheran Book of Worship 145. Lightning part is their favorite part. Hopefully because Jesus Christ is always by our side and gives us that glory and victory over all. May he be in your life today, and may you have joyful time with family and friends this morning. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you in favor and give you peace. Amen. Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Happy Easter, everyone. Yay.